Hello everyone, it is I again, Loki the Witch, and it is Monday, the 23rd, according to my computer. And I wanted to hope everybody had a good day, because I know people are like, oh, Mondays suck. But not always. Sometimes Mondays can be one of the better days of the week. I mean, I had a good day so far. Most of it I spent curled up in bed saying nope to everything. Because bed is warm, bed does not judge you much. Alrighty, today is obviously Monday, so it's tools and items, and today we're going to talk about two things, mortar and pestles, and wands. I'm going more in depth with these two things than I did one of my previous videos of just going over them. There are many different types of mortar and pestles. There's like this one, which is a smaller one, and right now, yes, I still have mint leaves in it, and they still smell good. It's obviously easy. You put the leaves or items in there, you crush it up with the mortar or the pestle, and then you stir and grind it, and it becomes close to powdery stuff. And I really got to remember what I was doing this one for. Yeah, that's another thing. If you leave something in there, make sure you remember what it's for. This will probably just go into my mint collection that I have already ground out, because I can use it in water and tea and let it steep and then have mint water. But this is chocolate mint that I have, so I will have chocolate mint water. It actually tastes a lot better than you think. And then there's other ones kind of like this. It's more of a bigger bowl shape. This one is actually Soren's. They haven't really used it yet, because it's a little newer. Have you used it yet, dear? No, they haven't used it yet. But if you notice, most of their bottoms will have something like this to keep from scratching, and also it keeps it from sliding, which is a good thing. Well, it slides in my hand. I mean, even mine has it, and my soap has the part of the Made in China tag. We got these both at the same store, which for us was an Asian store. So mine was like 15, and this one was 12. You'll notice that they're a solid color, and then they come a little dulled up here. That's because it's going to be grinding. And believe it or not, no, the stone does not mix in with the items that you are making. It, sometimes like this right now, because it's been used so much, it's a little stained with the mint, and I gotta eventually scrub that off. I've just been a little lazy. And sometimes your mortar and pestle will end up smelling like whatever you're grinding in here. So it is important to use a paper towel with a little bit of water to wash it out. I wouldn't suggest fully submerging these in water. So cleaning them out is easy. Just take a paper towel, a little bit of water, scrub it in there, and then use a paper towel to dry it out. Because the inside of this is as coarse as this, and they have little lines. You can't really see it, but if you can, to make it easier for grinding. You can use it for black salt. You can use it to mix black salt. You can use it for powders. You can use it for incense powders. You can use it to mix powders together to make different things. I've used dragon's blood and other incense powders together, mixed into it, and then put it into an item and lit the incense, which it smelled really good. Though I don't remember the exact stuff I used in it. It was one of those random spells off the fly. But mortar and pestles you can find at New Age stores. You can find them at Asian markets. You can find them at, believe it or not, you can find some of them in pharmacy areas or at a pharmacy. You can find them also at thrift stores. You can get a metal one, which works just as well. They're actually really pretty. I almost bought a couple sets of them from a thrift store. It's just, I didn't have the money at the time for them, and for the pack that we wanted, there was like 5 to 10 of them. It was a little bit more than the one I have. But at the time, like I said, I didn't have the money for it, and we were there to get a table anyways. But they're great. If you like doing herbs and potions and mixing things together or making powders, they're great to have. If you use them medical wise, because you don't want to take a pill or something, they're good to grind up your pill to make it into powder, to mix into water, or to take it as powder, whatever you like to do. Because I know some people who can't stomach pills and either grind them or open the capsule and dump it into the water and drink the entirety of the water, which sounds weird and gross, but apparently it does the same job, I guess. I have unique, interesting friends. More in depth with the wands. You can do your generic store-bought wands. I have obviously my selenite one that is like, but the selenite orbs is mostly used for helping with cord cuttings and such. And it is better for a healing wand, which we have a thicker, bigger one on our healing altar. This is my personal one that I've used in cord cuttings. And if you notice, yes, it looks a little banged up and odd and not polished or perfect, but it works just as well. Can also use it to add in a little bit of energy. But the selenite is also a very fun stone to have, and like I said, I have a lot of it. Then this is actually a ruby blue kyanite wand that I got a while back with it looks like small purple garnet stones and silver embossing on it. I use this more of a healing meditation, calming energy removal or addle. I've used it a grand total of 4 times, where I'd use this to go down to find the point and this to close it. It's kind of one of those kind of things. Opener, closer. But this set me back quite a bit when I got it. I got it when I was on financial aid and I had a lovely chunk of change I could blow. Because I'd already paid rent and bills. I did responsible things first. I got this and it was also on set and sell, and it was the first time they actually had it. But it is, for me, it's worth the buy for some things I do for others and for healing purposes. And this is one of my main ones that, where this is more for basic pulling. This is basic pulling for cords, and this is basic extraction and removal. It's an odd thing that I do with energy. I do a lot of energy work, if you haven't guessed. This is not a wand, but it's more of a pillar that I keep on my Loki side. It does have some of that ruby in it, and the green is not kyanite. I can't quite remember what the green is. I think it's a jade or another type of stone. I would have to double check. I bought it so long ago, I forgot what it was, and I apologize. But these can also act as sort of things because they do have a tip, and you can still run it down, and that feels weird. But it does actually project a lot of good energy and calming, and it is something that I don't ever think I will ever regret getting. It also set me back, but it was at the same time that I bought this guy, so I had a little bit of money to blow at that point. And then the other one I'm going to talk about is a wand similar to this, your generic wooden wand. Yes, this one was a store-bought, but it was also a hand-carved one. This one set me back 10 whole dollars because not only was it on clearance, but they wanted to find the right home for it. So a few people who wanted to buy it was told no, which I go with the owners. If they see something that doesn't work for a person, they will urge them to purchase something else. This does have amethyst on the end and on the tip right there in the mouth. It is carved in the way of a snake. And yes, it's not an even piece of wood. But it is a nice wand, and I've used this for being in circle work and some spell work. Carving a wand is not too hard. Eventually, I will be doing a video when I find the perfect stick or hunk of wood to carve into my own personal wand. This is just, I'm not sure what kind of wood it is, but it's pretty sturdy and is actually permanently stays on my Loki side. It's my representation of the Midgardian serpent. And no, I can't pronounce his name. I can spell it out kind of when it comes to typing. I just can't pronounce his name. But if you've noticed through even on that side of my altar when I show it, I have with the statue of Loki, there is the wolf representing Fenrir, and then he's holding the serpent that represents. Yeah. Let's just call him Jay for short because Nordics, you and your names. Really? Eventually, I will get something that represents Slimer. But he also roams more with Odin because that's the steed Odin uses. As for Helena, we don't go into that love-hate relationship with that one. Because I would love to have something that represents her, but at the same time, I haven't been able to find it. Because you don't really find many statues of a half-human, half-skeleton that split perfectly down the middle. Okay, that felt weird. But when it comes to wands, you want to get wands that work with you. This for me luckily works with me. And I don't always have to hold the tip of it. Which that's actually a bad habit. When I show wands to people, I will keep my finger on the tip. And I will never point the tip directly at people unless I'm working. It's just my energy weird thing. If you find or make wands that resonate with you, make sure that they do. You can make them for other people. Be careful, make sure that the person interacts with it before you finish it off. Make sure they're the ones who choose the stones that go into it. If you want to put stones, they choose what kind of markings they want on it, what kind of runes if they want runes. They choose what they want on it. Unless they just want a generic Harry Potter looking one, which, believe it or not, I do have actually his wand in toy form that lights up and makes a zoosh noise. Yeah, like I said, I'm still nerd for the Harry Potter stuff. I'm crying out loud, I have a Ravenclaw watch behind me on my altar. But making your own sometimes is best. Like I said, this one I've had for a while, actually, since I first moved to Washington. As for the other two, like I said, they're store-bought, made outwards, otherwise you can find wands pretty much made out of any stones. You can find some that are similar to this that has the chakra stones on it that are really good for Reiki work, chakra work, stuff like that, which eventually I will be getting Soren one. And I just have to find one that works with Soren and make them hold it and use it a little bit. But you'll find ones like this a little bit more typical out there, different stones, different colorations. Like I said, this is ruby kyanite. So you have that vibration and you have the purity of ruby. And ruby does come out looking purple originally before it's, I guess, polished to shiny, shiny, shiny to where it does come out red. But ruby is a fickle stone to begin with. Wand work is not that difficult, but it is something that if you're willing to look into and study, you'll see there's sometimes an art form to it. Another reason why you'll learn why best to do that if you're showing them. And when they're on my altar, the tip is always pointing towards the wall. I enjoy doing actually wand work. I have never had too bad of experience with it when it comes to using them for healing, extracting, cord cutting, and healing of issues and Yeah, it's a little wobbly. When things like this will become a little wobbly, either they'll have something that has them drilled in, or you'll have to take a little bit of glue, super glue, or stone solvent and put it on there to strengthen it. But like I said, this one is an older one, so I may have to eventually do that if the tip decides to come off. Just because it breaks, like this come off, it does not mean it's useless. It can be fixed and it can still be used. If it snaps in half, however, I would consider that way too much energy being put through it, or obviously it says it's done with its use, or it fell and broke. Things happen. That should be your decision if you want to fix it, or if you want to put it aside and let it rest until you decide if you need to fix it, or if you need to. Some people will return them to the earth, other people will put them on a shelf on display. Even broken doesn't lose its ability to do what it's supposed to do. With this, again, it is not safe, water safe. So this doesn't really go outside if I'm doing outside work or anything, because I live in Washington, and what is Washington famous for? Rain. So I tend to do my best not to get this one wet. With it being the fun clear white crystal, sometimes you do have to take a damp paper towel over it, but immediately take another dry one over it to dry it off quickly because we don't want it to dissolve. But they are useful. Regardless of whatever kind of stone you get them as, you can get a quartz wand, you can get a kyanite ones will set you back a lot. You can get a rosy quartz one, you can get an amethyst wand, you can get pretty much name the stone and you might be able to get it as a wand. As for wood wands, you have to be careful about what you get, what type you get, where you get it, or if you do it yourself. Like I said, this is a birch. That's what it is. It is stained so that it doesn't splinter, unlike my staff. Staffs can be used as a type of wand as well. But the way that works is a little bit differently. With this, so like I said, you find the wood that works with you. You can go with the wood that you're born in with that month or that. I know they have like different phrases, kind of like the zodiac has their months and things like Sagittarius or Capricorn or Aquarius. And you can go by the trees of the quarters too. Be careful what kind of wood you get. Because if you get things like from mistletoe, you can get stuff from the mistletoe trees or bushes. You can get wood from oak or poison oak by mistake. Know your plant, know your woods, know your trees. Be careful if you're going out into the woods and getting it. And that would be my rice cooker. But when you go out, be careful, be wary. You can go to a store and even buy a thing of wood and carve it down if you wanted to. It's all up to you how to make your wood wand. Like I said, eventually one of the videos will be doing a wand session where we build carve our own wand if you want to join. I may actually attempt to do that one as a live stream to more of in time instead of having to pause it and then show and then do all that fun editing stuff to numb it down and so people can ask questions as we go. But I'm still working on figuring out how to do live stream. That's another reason why I haven't hosted Heathen Haven, because I have Open Broadcast OBA. They use something else and I'm a little new at that one. So with that, and that is pretty much the more of the technical use of wands and where to get them and what types. Remember, wands can be used for healing, cord cuttings, energy work, spiritual work, circle work, anything like that. They can be used for pretty much everything, and even spell casting. I suppose, like, you can tap the jars with it to put your things in. You can do stuff like that. Mortar and pestles, great to make herbs and powders thinner and better, and mixing. These are two, the mortar and pestle is something that, like I said, that it's an optional thing if you like to do potions and herb mixtures and incense mixer. I don't think it works for incest mixtures. I don't know. Incense is what I mean. I apologize. I think I'm getting a sore throat again. But wands are definitely something I would suggest everybody having one of. Little towers like this, I would suggest as well, at least one. I know Soren has a selenite spiral tower that they keep on their altar, and I'm not going to show you that one because I don't like touching that one for some reason. I don't do good with spirals. But to each their own. So I hope this was a little informational on some things and how things work. If you want to know more, let me know in the comments or shoot me a message. I will have my Twitter and all that stuff up like normal. So you can even reach me on Twitter to ask questions or suggestions for next tool videos. If you want to know more about something, just let me know, and blessed be.